finally, my brothers, rejoice in the Lord. It is no trouble for me to write this to you again, as it is a safeguard to you. Watch out for those dogs, those evildoers, those mutilators of the flesh. For it is we who are the circumcision, we who serve God by His Spirit, who boast in Christ Jesus and put no confidence in the flesh. Although I myself have reasons for such confidence. If someone here believes that you have reason to put confidence in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, in regard to the law, a Pharisee. As for zeal, I persecuted the church. As for righteousness based on the law, I was faultless. But whatever were gains to me, I now consider loss. And what is greater, I consider everything a loss compared to the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage. It's rubbish that I may gain Christ and be found in Him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which is comes from God on the basis of faith. You see, I want to know Christ. I want to know the power of His resurrection. I want to participate in His sufferings, becoming like Him even unto death, so that somehow I may obtain the resurrection from the dead. Now, brothers, it is not that I have obtained all of this. It is not that I have arrived at my goal, but what I do, I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me. And I don't consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but the one thing I do, it is forgetting what is behind and straining on toward what is ahead. I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. And brothers, for those gathered here today, those of us who are mature in the faith, we should take such a view of things. And if on some point you think differently, I pray that God will make that clear to you as well. Join together in following my example, brothers. Take note of those who live according to the pattern that has been laid out for you, because I have told you before and I will tell you again, even with tears in my eyes, many live as enemies to the cross of Christ. For their destiny is destruction, and their God is their stomach, and their glory is in their shame, for their minds are set on earthly things. But our citizenship is in heaven. And we eagerly await a Savior from there, who is the Lord Jesus Christ, who has the power to bring all things under His control. And someday He will transform our lowly bodies to become like His glorious body. Therefore, my brothers, you whom I love, you are my joy, my crown. This is how we stand firm in the Lord.